The All Blacks may have thumped the Wallabies in the Bledisloe Cup over the weekend, but the other headline from the match was, of course, the massive head knock that Ryan Crotty sustained. One News sports reporter, Guy Heveldt, is here with us this morning. Morning, Guy.
Morning, Jack.
We'll talk about the game in a minute, but I want to focus on Ryan Crotty for a little bit. He's had numerous head injuries over the years, and clearly there is a lot of concern about how serious this might be.
This is his sixth in 2 years. The numbers are pretty startling and pretty concerning. Yeah. And Steve Hansen said as much yesterday. He said, look, we're all really concerned. The thing is, and I mean, I personally did this as well. As soon as it happened, you kind of jumped to the, oh, maybe he should start looking at retirement.
Yeah.
And that's the big question. And, you know, players have come out and said, oh, look, we'll see what happens. We'll see how he recovers. I asked him about this in June after his fifth one in 2 years. And it was quite a heavy one. I think it was against the Blues.
Yeah.
And he said, look, they're all quite different, and that's the big thing here. They're all different in the sense that that one there might have looked quite bad, but he says he's actually recovered. He's been cleared by a specialist, as Steve Hansen said yesterday. And the one in June against the Blues was very, very innocuous, but it actually took a long time to recover. So they're all quite different in how he recovers and all that sort of stuff. And I think we just got to, you know, take a step back. There are medical doctors and experts out there who are looking at it, who know a little bit more about it than us. And look, I suppose he'll get all the attention he needs. But it is, at the moment, the massive point in the game is concussion and players suffering all these and how they recover. So it's going to be a debate that continues.
It's interesting. We had on the show a few months ago Dr. Bennett Omalu, who was the scientist in the US who first started talking about brain injuries in the NFL and in football in the US, and he said that he wouldn't play rugby. If that was an option to him, he wouldn't play it because he thinks it's too dangerous. Like you say, this is something we're becoming more aware of, and they've made some changes in the game, but it's still a massive risk.
And we're still learning about it.
Yeah.
We're still massively learning about it. I mean, there are guys in the NFL who are finishing their careers 20, 30 years on who are then suffering memory loss, headaches, all this other stuff that then they're linking back to concussions that they suffered in the NFL playing days.
Mm.
So that is the big issue in rugby at the moment, is how to fix that. They have introduced things in terms of the HIA, which is where they go off during a game and an independent doctor assesses them. They didn't need that on Saturday night, unfortunately, because Ryan Crotty was so knocked out. It was a really ugly incident. But again, I think we just need to sit back for a minute and just go, okay, let's just see how he recovers.
Yeah, well, this is the thing. I mean, everyone's going to be a bit chanting retirement and all that sort of stuff. It's easy when, you know, you don't have skin in the game and you don't have any medical qualifications whatsoever to be an expert all of a sudden. I suppose we're just in a point now where we need to wait a few weeks and see what medical professionals say.
Yeah, but it is concerning.
It is really concerning. I mean, the other thing is that, like, from my understanding, the science around TBIs and traumatic brain injuries is still really, like, rudimentary, relatively speaking.
Yep.
And so, I mean, doctors themselves are still learning more about this.
One thing we should say, David Pocock, brilliant. The sportsmanship shown by him to hang around Ryan Crotty for, it was about 3 or 4 minutes.
Yeah, just
to make sure he was right. I thought that was awesome.
Yeah, so did I. I agree. Hey, very quickly, what did you make of the game itself and the Black Ferns?
Yeah, the Black Ferns were great, weren't they? And I can't wait for the doubleheader again this weekend. Yeah. Let's hope they get a big crowd. Look, the All Blacks were pretty rusty, I suppose, in the first 35. But as they always do, they scored before halftime. They scored straight after halftime, and it changed the game. Brody Retallick, everyone's talking about Brody Retallick, and why not? He was just unbelievable, wasn't he?
Dummy,
and that try he scored, that just put the icing on the cake.
Yeah.
But he didn't put a foot wrong. And other than that, I thought the All Blacks were pretty darn good overall as well. And I can't see the Wallabies getting close to them at Eden Park. 1986 was the last time the Wallabies beat the All Blacks at Eden Park. I think they'll be waiting another year.
It's a wee while, eh? Yeah. Hey, how often do you wash your sheets?
Try and do it weekly.
Sure.
No, honestly.
Sure you do.
You know my girlfriend is pretty dependent on that sort of stuff. Try and do it weekly. Probably doesn't average out to quite that.
Okay, yeah.
Maybe not
52 times in a year, but more or less weekly. Okay, thank you very much, guys. We appreciate it.